What's going on, guys? My name is Oriya Token, and today we're going to talk about this kind of grenade launcher that's new to the season called maybe the Ignition Code? Something like that. I don't know. Something like an oppressive, almost mountaintop look-like. So, nothing big. Just an Ignition Code. We'll talk about that today. Let's go ahead and get started. Alright, so why is this weapon good? What makes it so good? Let's talk about what random roles it can come with. The first column is usually its launch, basically how fast or slow and different things about the launch happens. The second is the grenade, the actual bullet of the grenade launcher, what it does. And then the next two are perks about the grenade launcher. So let's talk about the first one, talking about what things here make it so good. Looking at the start, we have different things here that increase our blast radius and our velocity. The velocity is already a 75 and blast radius is already a 55, so it's got a decent velocity and blast radius. So anything on top of that will actually add to the blast radius, and we'll talk about blast radius itself a little later as well with the perks. So what I would recommend here is either linear compensator gives you +5 to basically stability, velocity, blast radius, and that's very good. Or if you really, really just want to have more velocity, quick launch is great as well. But also, let's not count out, smart drift control gives you so many other things on the gun, like stability, handling, and recoil, that you can't forget about. So don't forget about those. Looking at our grenades, so we're going to focus on two separate focuses here, PvE and PvP. So let's talk about PvE first. Your DPS king is going to be spike grenades. Spike grenades will basically direct impact the boss, or whatever you're shooting at, and it does increased damage on direct hits. That's what you're going to use for your DPS. After that, blinding grenades is also very good. It's like basically throwing a flashbang in Call of Duty. It blinds the enemy targets, so it really helps when you're under fire. You can shoot that and just disorient the opponents so they can't see anything that's going on there. And those are my PvE selections. Looking at PvP, I would also stick with spikes. Direct impacts will just wreck kids. High velocity rounds are great too because it increases that velocity. But I also like to look, I like to use blinding grenades sometimes. If I'm looking to disrupt folks, not necessarily kill them, be more support, I would go with the blinding grenades. But overall, my personal choice is going to be spike grenades. Now, let's go over to the next two perk columns. This is where this grenade launcher becomes the most OP grenade launcher in the game right now. Mountaintop is sunset. Mountaintop had basically it was overpowered, and they promised to not bring it back. But then they put this out, and we'll talk about what's so overpowered about it. And this goes for PvE and PvP. There's a perk called Slide Shot that is on this weapon. Let's read what that says. Sliding partially reloads this weapon's magazine and temporarily boosts range and stability. What you can do with this is you shoot a bullet, slide, shoot, slide, shoot, slide, shoot, slide, shoot, slide. It's ridiculous. You can get your ammo back into your magazine so fast. Reload stats don't matter. They just don't matter at all. You don't have to reload. It just gives you your ammo back. That is massive. You can see in the background gameplay, I have put in some gameplay of me doing this. It's insane. And then tag along with that, you have either Danger Close, Vorpal, One for All, and Frenzy. Two damage buffs with Vorpal and Frenzy, and three and One for All. And then Danger Close, the brand new perk that says the blast radius of the weapon increases while surrounded by combatants. That is massive. Not only can you slide and shoot things, you have a bigger blast radius, watch out, you could kill yourself, and you have damage perks. Get your grenades faster, and you shoot things, and it kills them with more damage. Hits them with more damage. It's ridiculous. It's crazy. So that's that right there makes this ridiculous. Looking at the first column again, you have Ambitious Assassin. That is a PvE god. Getting two bullets in the mag is always great for DPS, especially with spikes. Then you have Quick Draw, which is also good when you're in a combat situation. You just pull out your grenade launcher if you're running with a primary weapon, a kinetic weapon. Huge. And then looking at the final perk, like I said, Vorpal, One for All, Frenzy, and Danger Zone. It's crazy what this can do. This also synergizes perfectly with the artifact. I mean, this was meant to be a grenade launcher season, but it's great in PvE. But you go to PvP and you just get grenade launcher spam. Is that what they're trying to do with stasis? Is it counter stasis with grenade launch? I don't know. It's a little oppressive. And let's walk through the artifact right now. All right, so first thing, we have grenade launcher scavenger. This gives you more ammo when you run over a special brick. So you take this, you run over a special brick. Instead of getting one, you get two or three, depending on how many stack on your character. You can put two of these on your leg armor as a mod. So you run double scavs, you get extreme amount of grenades back as you find one. So you shoot one, kill somebody, get three. Shoot one, kill somebody, get seven. Whatever it is, it stacks on the number special that they drop. That is disgusting because you're always going to have grenade launcher ammo in PvP because basically everybody runs special. You get a kill, they drop ammo, you pick it up. Perfect. Also, this pairs amazing on Titan with Inertia Override. You slide over special ammo using Slide Shot, reloading your weapon, giving you a damage boost. It's crazy. It works so well together, especially on that Titan class. After that, we're going to look at the next one, which is going to be our Blast Radius. Charged with Light mod, which makes you become charged light after rapidly defeating enemies with this grenade launcher. So in PvE and PvP, if you get a triple down, double down, you can become charged light, giving yourself more damage if you have a charged light build on your character. So not only can you direct impact somebody, you can proximity kill somebody with charged light. If you direct impact somebody, you do 213 to the body, kills anybody, just wipes them out. Insane. After that, we have grenade launcher dexterity. This says faster ready and stow speeds for grenade launchers. So you slide over special ammo, you get inertia override, you might swap your weapon to primary, come back, you can easily get your grenade launcher and shoot somebody quickly. It's almost like quick draw, you know, and you don't need quick draw at that point if you have double dexterities on. So put that on your arms, your arm armor, and you don't need quick draw. You can have slide shot and quick draw built in on the gun. Just disgusting, crazy. Then the next two are more PvE perks. Let's talk about them. Unstoppable Grenade Launcher and Breach and Clear. These two, basically, the Unstoppable Grenade Launcher is self-explanatory. You shoot it and it stuns the unstoppable boss. The next one though, Breach and Clear. What this does, it says when using a grenade launcher, damaging a boss, champion, or breaking a combatant shield, reloads your stow weapon, reloads it automatically, then it causes the combatant to take increased damage for a short duration. So not only do you get another bullet back, you also get to do more damage to the person, so you can chaos reach them, you can just melt them. This is going to be great for Grandmaster Nightfalls and endgame content. For Vault of Glass, I mean, that's going to be amazing, using grenade launcher in Vault of Glass. You know, you were never been able to do that before, so grenade launchers themselves are going to be massive this season, and Ignition Code is going to be the catalyst to get there with what we've talked about on this gun. So please go ahead, grind out the seasonal content to get this, because it is disgusting. Please go get this. Once I saw this gun was available, I decided that with the artifact and everything on it, I had to get it. It was just going to be too strong. So hopefully you guys can also farm this weapon because it is very strong, and I hope that you can use it to its capabilities. I know grenade launchers in PvP are oppressive. I know that. And this is going to make them more oppressive. I understand that. But let me tell you, getting a direct impact and using it as a team shot against things like Dead Man's Dale or Stasis, especially Stasis, it pairs really well. This is a pop. The Ignition Code is a kinetic. Your first slot grenade launcher. You don't get those very often, so go ahead and use it and enjoy. Once again, my name is Oreo Token. Hopefully, you guys have a great day. Have fun farming this weapon and have fun using this weapon. I'll see you guys on the flip side. Come check me out on Twitch. Also, the other videos of the weapon reviews for the season, we're gonna knock those out as well. Thank you guys for stopping by. Have an amazing day. Bye-bye.